tell you another story with the Saba of Shipoli. Saba of Shipoli, in his town, he heard that there was a tightrope walker coming into town. And now his whole show, this is what he hears, his whole show was he takes a tightrope, he connects it from one mountain to another. They have this in China, by the way, every single day. They tie it from one mountain to another mountain, and he goes on a tightrope, and everybody's clapping their hands, and it's a spectacle. You really have to see this. So when the Saba of Shipoli heard this, he says, "Take me there. I want to see this." Now, his students told him, "You know, Rabbi, Rebbe, it's beneath you. You're going to see a tightrope walker? Go learn Torah, Rabbi." But, you know, as much as they tried to tell him, "Rabbi, it's not for you, it's beneath you, it's not befitting you," he said, "No." He was an Akshan, he was stubborn. I want to go. Finally, he went. And now they see him, they see their Rebbe looking at this tightrope walker like this, in amazement, like he's seeing him, like going from one end to another. Dun, 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 see? Beautiful, the music came out in time. So they see him, they see the rabbi amazed, his jaw dropped at the guy walking the tightrope. And when he finishes, they ask him, "You know, Rabbi, what's doing? Like, why did you want to go see this tightrope walker?" So he tells them, "I learned a great musar from this tightrope walker." "What was the musar, Rabbi, that you learned?" He said, "Of course this tightrope walker is making money, right? He's getting paid to walk this rope, of course. But at the time that he's walking the rope, he doesn't think about money. He doesn't think about his house. He doesn't think about his car. He doesn't think about any of his luxuries. He doesn't think about anything. The only thing he's thinking about is that I better not look down, because if I look down, that's it. I'll be worried. I'll be afraid. I'll be nervous. And that's it. It's over for me. It's the end for me." He was so merukaz. He was so concentrated, he pinpointed on this mission that he has to do right now, to walk the tightrope, and he blocked everything around him. He says, that's the musar we have to learn when it comes to learning Torah. When it comes to learning Torah, you come to a class, everything around you should be on pause, on hold. Nothing matters in your life, nothing. Not your wife, not your children, not your business transactions, not anything around you. Nobody. You put your phone on silent, you come into that class, you listen to that class for whatever amount of whatever duration it is, because that's the only way that Torah can stay inside of you, and that is your salvation, and that is your mayim. Yes, you quench your thirst, your physical thirst, with water, but how can you quench your spiritual thirst that the neshama is craving every single day? The only way, en mayim ella Torah.